Okay, here's some of the insulators that I have lined up around the tip on. These are some of the ones that I like the most in my collection. This is just a portion of what I have. I decided to put them out here in the sunlight today. It's a really nice day. Have them lined up here on the table and I'll have them listed at some good, but of course starting out for the front right here is my Muncie that I have, CD 303310. And a nice green aqua. Be moving on to some of the ones over here. These are some of the Californias that I have. One of them I think is a CD 161, and that would be in blue aqua. That one right there is in a light green, and then the 162 signals. There's some nice blue aqua, and a smoky purple. And a CD 145 Brookfield. This one should be in a yellow green, probably close to emerald green as well. Some of my CD 133s. These ones in emerald green and ones in aqua. These both came off of the Baltimore and Ohio, from according for what I was told when I acquired these from a friend. Some hoop skirts, CD 152s. One is in a dark yellow green. And the other one is in a regular green. The dark yellow green is in close to mint condition. It's got some of the moldings on the bottom of the hoop skirt on the inside of it. And I'll be able to see that part that's on the ring right here. And I see it looks like it's got the amber swirls in it, which is really cool. Another Brookfield, it's got some milk swirls in it and a small stone. D512, some of my ponies. One's a Brookfield with a backward 7 embossed on the dome, and it's in depressed green. Some light aqua, some milky light ice green, lighter aqua, dark purple, olive. Dark olive. And the road that's back here is CD 160, a baby signal. And some 162s. Some of them are in hemi blues and aquas. Some more beehives. Another Brookfield. Hemingway 21 beehive. The later mold. And an ice green petticoat beehive. Hemingway. New England glass manufacturer beehive, and a jade aqua Hemingway beehive, and it does have some amber swirls in there too, which is cool. And a common insulator that we all know of, which is the CD 154, and this one is green. And root beer amber. And a red amber signal. And a Lynchburg CD 154. And it's in ginger ale. Nice star embossed blue signal. Blue aqua. 133.4 beat bullet. From the weeping show that I got not too long ago. And a fourth series Brookfield beehive with double bee embossed on each side of them. Some more Brookfield signals. This one I got from a little pick. It's got a big chunk of amber swirl in the top. And another Brookfield hoop skirt, and this one has drip points on it. I'm not sure how common those are to find. and a couple of, on the front here, I got a couple of these CD214s. Went to Altatum, probably in a light, no, clear Mickey Mouse, and a Hemi Blue CD154 with sharp grip points on it. I picked this Sobrando. Another Brookfield hoop skirt, This one just has embossed number 40 on it. Not sure that's visible to the camera. And a really early CD214 with the larger grooves on the top of it. These were when they were starting to make them. A Gainer CD154 and a light blue, light aqua. And an early CD154 in clear or light blue. I picked that off the Great Western. Dome embossed Brookfield Beehive. It's double-sided embossed. And 162.4 signal, Canadian SDP 1678. And another Lynchburg CD154. And a light aqua and an ice blue CD214 and a couple of Brookfield Beehives. This one's double-sided dome embossed. This one's from 1884. The Cliff Street embossed on it. I think they have a Taylor Street one somewhere, but and a earlier Brookfield. And the last one right here is another beehive, but it has the Holly Insulator Company embossed on the side of it, which is really cool. Yeah, that's pretty much a portion of what I have, but let me know what you think. Like, comment below on what's your favorite one that I have here so far. More of my pictures of insulators will come on to Flickr. That'll be linked. That link is on my YouTube channel, and I might link it in the description below. So take care and be sure to watch and subscribe for more videos that I'll have more on my insulator collection. And if you have any further questions, I feel free to answer below, and I'll be happy to answer. So take care and see you next time.